Boxing legend Iron Mike Tyson wasn't the tallest fighter, but one of his strongest weapons was the short hook. We're here with boxing trainer, fitness expert Brandon Kraus. Tell us about the short hook.
You know, terrific short punches on the inside from Iron Mike. Tony Zale had a great short hook to the head that he would set up via body shot. And you go throughout history, you know, a lot of top guys, guess what, had a great inside game as well. You know, and you want to think of them as completely separate. On the outside, in my boxing world, in my mathematical world, I set things up via jab distance. I try to fill that distance with other long punches. I try to time my opponent. I use my movement. I use the majority of my straight shots, and I come with that hook every now and then. I come with a body shot every now and then. When I'm really on that boxing game, I'm primarily working on those straight shots. Now, when I allow my opponent to get closer to me, or when he works his way closer to me, I have to fight with him in more of a short range of attack, or a short game of attack. And they're completely different. You know, the way that you generate this power is different. The punches that are available to you are different, right? When I got a guy out here on the end of my jab, you know, maybe I can pump the right hand on him, set up a longer left hook, come off of it. Maybe I can step that foot in here off the jab and hook off it.
Oh, hold on one second. Let's bring a body.
Art, will you come here for a second?
Okay.
So here's Art, who's much taller than me, right? And
uh-huh.
Me, if I was boxing on the outside and he had me on the end of his jab, I would be forced to have to come with long-range shots in order to match him at this range. But that would be silly, because he's naturally taller than me anyway.
He'll keep you on the outside.
He's going to be a lot better at the outside game than I am. Now, if I can get inside on Art and really close the distance, and when I say close range, guys, I'm talking close. I'm talking like chest to chest, or hip to hip, as I like to say. I got to generate power on my hooks, but I cannot keep the range of motion great. So how do I do that? Is I rely a hell of a lot more on my hips and my body. And I basically just put these in a punching position, and then my hip is what's driven here. So Art's on the end of my jab, and like I said before, I can pump the right hand at him, and then turn left hook when there's a great bout of distance, right? When I'm close, what I need to do is snap my hip as hard as I can, and this fist and my shoulder really are not gonna move all that much, and I get that power. You can see here, I got my hand on my hip, so you can see how much more my hip moves.
Okay.
My fist. And then when I'm on the outside, it's kind of the reverse happens. My fist doesn't end up moving, my hip doesn't end up moving as far as my fist when I have room to snap it. But when that room to snap is gone, I have to regenerate the snap via my hips, via
okay.
my legs.
Here's my question. Let's say you missed those two shots, but you already used the momentum and you're out of Now, Art could capitalize on that. How do you?
Yeah, I mean, look, there's no punch that doesn't have a counterpunch. There's no end-all, be-all technique. So,
okay.
Yeah, absolutely, this is our chess match. And I would want to link shots together, and I would want to have some sense of anticipation of what Art was going to do. What I like to tell my outlaws is when we're on the inside, I kind of lose the luxury of vision. And now what I have to do is use feeling, right? So if I stay hip to hip with Art, and let's say Art starts throwing a right hook at me, I can feel his body starting to commit. And as he starts moving, I know the fucker wants to hit me in the head. He doesn't want to give me a kiss. So he just goes with that right hook, feel his body, and I'm able to dip. Or let's say it was on the other side here, and he goes for left hook. Once I feel his body starting to move, starting to commit to something, I'll know I better get my head out of the way there.
Okay, last question, coach. What's the best way to work on the short hook?
Well, there's many ways to work on the hooks, and you should employ all of them. One cool one is on the speed bag. Everybody knows, you know, the more traditional way to hit the speed bag. That is a great way to learn how to build your timing, to build some stamina in your arms as well. But specifically working on your hooks there is a great idea. Now you saw how close I was to Art. So I'm not gonna get far away from my speed bag here. I'm gonna get right up on it. And what I wanna learn how to do is generate a lot of power without a lot of room. And look, it's a sequence, meaning one piece happens before the other. My foot started to rotate, which forces my hip to rotate, which builds up power in my trunk. Then the shoulder comes, and that power is transferred in my shoulder. And then as the fist starts to turn over, that power works its way out my arm through the fist. And again, I'm going to really exaggerate it right here so you see the sequence. But from the foot up to the fist.
Hold on, let me back up, Brennan.
So again, exaggerating it a great deal. Foot, hip, shoulder, fist. Oh. And by the time I get to the end, there's a whole lot of power stored. So here, watch. Hip first. Boom. Now, if I were to bring this hip back to position with my fist, look, it's like I cocked my fist. It's like I went, boom. But I never want to do that in boxing. What I want to do is get that hip going first and get the same benefit, boom, 0 to 100 miles an hour with that. Here, Ellie, come here.
So how do you use it with the...
Well, let me show you something. Let me show you the real beauty of this punch and how short it is. I can be butted right up to a wall right here where there's next to no room. And still get significant power, at least enough power to hurt an opponent. Or here on the left side, boom. One of my favorite shots, that short. Here, bring your camera over here so we can show the viewers this gap, Ellie. Look right here.
12 inches.
About. Just about 12 inches. And right there, look, my fist doesn't even ride right there. And I can get tons of power, enough to knock somebody out if I can hit him.
Brennan, can you give me 3 punches from this side and 3 punches from that side?
Sure. So here's some lessons.
Ha! Miss. It's okay.
Get on that right side for the same. Watch some things. My chin tucks as I punch. I hide it behind my shoulder. And the other guard, the hand I'm not punching with, remains in a good defensive position.
All right, there you have it. Brennan Krause with a great explanation about the short hooks. FaceReport.com and Melissa Back reporting.